Good morning, everyone, and Merry Christmas, the last day for Christmas. And the purpose of Christmas is what? Our happy birthday to Jesus, right? We celebrate Jesus' birth. That's the purpose of our Christmas. And kids enjoy Christmas, they love Christmas too, right? The gifts. I hope everyone got what they wanted. Some of you are like, no. But for the soul, I hope you got what you needed. The gift of Jesus. Before I start, I'm going to pray. Father, Heaven, Lord, praise you. You came down from heaven on earth for us all to be born in the poorest place, from the richest place up there. Because you loved us so much. You sacrificed for us. I thank you for that. Holy Spirit, you're a fighter. As I preach your word, Lord, fill me, Lord, that give a 3-hour sermon today. I'm just kidding about that one. I keep it short and simple. Holy Spirit, low in us all. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We don't want to. Titanic sermon, right? We start off with the comics. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to your Jesus. Happy birthday to you. I hope you did that. Do it again tonight. Heads up, fellas. I think we have trouble. I don't think the elf was in there. When I grow up, I'm going to be a missionary in the North Pole so I can meet Santa Claus. Today's topic, what do you think it is? What? I can't hear the sign. We had countdown to Christmas, preparing for Christmas, and what was last week's? I forgot you. The fourth one, the Christmas gift, the Christmas gift. As we know, today is Christmas Day. Some of you had to get up early, open your presents really early, and hurry here. Most of us already opened our gifts. Some of us open on the 24th, Christmas Eve. Some traditions are different. Some open Christmas morning. Different. All your gifts already open? Maybe some of you are mad at me today for having church service because you haven't opened your gifts yet. If you haven't, light bulb, I'm sorry. Not really. But I do hope you got what you wanted for Christmas. Christmas meaning, Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. To us a child is born, a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. God has sent his son on earth for us all. The gift. He knew we all have a struggle. We have a problem we need to fix, right? It was a problem that we couldn't fix. No matter how hard we tried, we couldn't fix our problem. What was the problem? Sin. What's the problem? Sin. It corrupted us, our souls, and separated us from God. When we're bad, we behave really bad. We get punished, right? It's normal. We continue to get in trouble. We get punished. We don't tend to give gifts. We don't give gifts for murder in jail. Do they get gifts? No. Or different crimes. They don't get gifts. They go to jail, some for the rest of their lives. Right? But God, He sent the gift to us. No matter what we did in life, He gave His Son. And His Son was willing to give up what He had up there, a perfect life, to be born in the poorest area. Imagine that. Because He loved us, He wanted to give the best gift. And Jesus knew what the best gift was, His own life. You're going down there, you're going to die in about 33 years. What? But Jesus said, yes, my life is the gift to them. Because I know they need it. He gave it. That is the gift of salvation. Because He loved us so much. He gave it to us all. It's under every Christmas tree. Everywhere. That gift is for everyone. It's a gift right there under the tree. Merry Christmas. Love Jesus. It's for everyone. And everyone has the opportunity to take it, unwrap it, open it, yep, and receive it. It's for everyone. It's awesome. It's better than anything you ever received in your life. Better than your iPads, better than your PlayStation 4, better than your new puppies and kitties if you got that for Christmas, or new car. That was the best gift He'd given. It beats that. He gave it to you because He loved you all. That was His Christmas gift to you all. Matthew chapter 1, verse 21. She, talking about Mary, will give birth to a son. They will name Him Jesus because He will save people from their sins. That's awesome. Because we all have sin. We have sin. No matter how hard I try to wash it off. A Brillo pad, you know? The strongest cleaner. We couldn't do it. Everything I try, I can't. Boom, there's a gift right there. I open it up. It's Jesus. The blood. Spray the blood. They wash the sins away. A gift of life. It cost a life, a precious life, to give you life. That's a gift. John chapter 1, verse 10 to 12. He was in the world. Through the world was made through Him. The world didn't recognize Him. He came, which was His own. But His own didn't receive Him. But yeah, those who received Him, those who believe in His name, He gave us the right to be called children of God. He gave us life to wash our sins away. He also gave you a name tag, Joey Contreras, Son of God. Your name. Daughter of God, Son of God, Child of God. He gave us the right to become His children. He adopted us. He gave us everything in heaven. Those who call on His name. So when we get into heaven, it's ours as well. You know, when you say, my home is your home, well, mi casa, tu casa. My home is your home. That's what God is saying. That is my home, but it's your home as well. That's my gift as well. When you get there, welcome home. He adopted us. Adoption papers he signed. Your name is there. The book of life. When you accepted him as a savior, call his name, the book of life. My new adopted son. Boom. My new adopted daughter. Boom. Your name is signed there. So that's one of the gifts he's given. Salvation. To cure the curse of sin. The best gift he's given us all. Number two, the gift of joy. This comes with the gift of salvation. When you get Christmas gift, you're excited. My girls opened the Christmas gift this morning, they're excited. Yay! I've been wanting this. Ooh, and they smile. Me, I'm like, yay! I got a new blanket. I'm excited. I got an angel's blanket. I needed one. My Scooby-Doo one was old. Yes, I have a Scooby-Doo one. Scooby-Doo, you know that? Yikes! It was old. It was worn out. I'm excited. Now I can sleep warm now. I don't have to freeze to death anymore. Now with joy. Why? Because you can smile no matter what happens in life. Because you know this is temporary. Life is short. We all know that. We have experienced our loved ones going home or leaving. It's part of life. We know it's short. It's not long. And we know living on earth is tough. It's not easy. But we have joy of knowing where we're going. Because he has said, my home is your home. And my home is eternity. Here, 70, 80 years, max 120 maybe. It's short, still short. But there is eternity. So we enjoy. Luke chapter 1, verse 14. He will be a joy and a delight to you. And many will rejoice because of his birth. We rejoice at his birth. 2,000 years ago. So we know that saved us. Because of that, we have joy. Knowing that one day we sleep, we'll be up there in peace. Knowing I don't have to worry what's going on in the future. Every one of us think about the future on earth, right? Next year, I'm going to work at this. I'm going to buy this, this, this. We think about it. It's normal. We think about the future. Will this happen? Will I get a better job? Will I get promoted? Will I get a new car? We think about that. We wonder. But we don't have to wonder where we go when we die. This is the gift he's given us of salvation. I know one day I will die. But I know where I'm going. So I have joy for that. It's exciting to know I don't have to worry about my future. It's taken care of. My soul is already taken care of. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning the shame. And then he sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Jesus went through her. Then he went back home, the right hand of God. Now the joy. We're full of joy. Do we show that we're full of joy? There's a show in our face. I want to tell you a story. A long time ago, there was a group of prospectors. They're looking for gold in Montana. They're looking for gold. They went so many hard times. Looking. They felt discouraged, disappointed. They kept looking. They couldn't find gold. Look. They're disappointed. The group traveled back to town. One of his friends says, "See that area? I'm gonna try. Boom. Found some gold. Yeah. And the rest went over there. Boom. They found gold. They found about $50 worth of gold. Right now, about $50 somewhere. But a long time ago, that was worth a lot of money. So they know there's a lot more gold there. So they're excited. Problem is, their supplies is low. They needed more equipment. So what they had to do, they had to go back to town and get more supplies to go back. So all of them just got, "We're going to be quiet. Shh. We're going to hunt for gold. We're rich. We'll be rich." They're excited. Shh. They went back to town. They bought the supply. And they left. You know what happened? Behind them, 100 people following them. Who told on them? Who told them? No one. You know why they were following them? Gold! You know, the joy? We found gold. So you know they found something, because they were full of joy. They saw it on their faces. That's the problem, full of joy. And the people see the same in you too? Whoa, I'm smiling worse than a joker. What's up? I have Jesus. Full of joy. That hurts. See, joy, it brings people. That's how we bring people to Jesus. That's how we show the gift is awesome. I saw a video of a guy getting a PlayStation 4. He's so excited, yay! Do you do the same thing when we see Jesus Christ? Yeah, I'm excited. I have Jesus in my heart. Sing the song, "Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart." Number three, he gives us the gift of peace. We have joy because we have the peace of knowing the future is already set for us. When mom and dad comes, don't worry about it. When it's time for me to go home, everything is yours. Like, yes. We know the future is set. Same with God saying, don't worry about it. Everything is yours. My home is your home. The comfort having that. The stress. We have everyday stress in life. But the best thing is we don't have to worry about where we're going. You have Jesus in your heart. You believe in him. You have that true peace of knowing. Now consider what happens after I die. Is there an afterlife? What's going to happen? I'm sure it'll be stressful. We have the peace of knowing that he gave this gift already. God's in control. It's a free gift. Romans chapter 5, verse 1. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. He's promised us. We will have a home up there. Promised us. No pain up there. The best boots. The best drink. the freshest water, the ocean. I always say I like to swim with the sharks and not get bitten. He adopted us, the joy of having the sins forgiven. He's given us a new start in life. Even though sometimes here, we struggle with a new start in life. But He gave us a new start in life. A clean slate. He gave that to us. The cure from the disease of sin. Let's get John 16:33. I have told you these things, so that in me you have peace. In this world you will have troubles. But take heart, I have already overcome the world. He promises peace, and He lets us know we have troubles in this world. It's natural because of sin. But we have peace of knowing where we're going. He will take care of us. He will lead us through the hard times. He's promised that. No matter how chaotic life becomes, He is there with us. I have another story to read to you. There was this old lady on Christmas, 4 days before Christmas. Every year, she used to decorate her house beautifully. But this year, she didn't, because her husband died 3 months ago from cancer. She was sad. She felt alone. She didn't feel excited about Christmas, because her husband was gone. Later that day, she heard the doorbell ring, or flashing for us, deaf people, ding, ding, ding. She went to the door. She opened up. There was this guy with a box. Hello, good morning. I have a gift for you. I need you to sign here. What is this? Sign it. She signed it. He opened it up. Gave her a 6-month-old puppy. What is this? Why do I have a puppy? Well, your husband, 6 months ago, before he died, he bought this puppy from a predator dog and rearranged it. He would deliver it to you at 6 months when it was ready to have a new owner. He knew you would be lonely, but you needed a friend. Through these hard times, he's given this gift to you. He planned it, gave him a puppy. Merry Christmas from your husband. And he says he loves you. He's watching over you every day. The gift. Even though in hard times, it still appears. Even though in hard times we have in life, He appears, He helps us, gives us peace. She wiped her tears away. She felt inspired again. She picked up the puppy and went down in the basement, took out all the Christmas decorations. She went out. Even though in her old age, she put it all up with a smile. Peace because of the gift. And she sang joy to the world, and the neighbors came back and looked at it, pretty decoration, because of the gift of love. Same with Jesus. He's given us a gift of love. He gave up His life to wash our sins away. The gift of salvation, the gift of joy, the gift of peace. That's what He's given us all. And you are to receive it and remember that. Celebrate Christmas. Even though today is the last day of Christmas. But the gift that Jesus gives doesn't end. It's all year round. We thank Him for that. He continues loving us. Philippians chapter 4, verse 7. Don't be anxious about anything, but in every situation, prayer and petition of thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and your minds in Jesus Christ. He gave us all those gifts. And we open them. Remember every day, open them. Receive those gifts. I hope you already opened your gifts. If you haven't opened your gift to Jesus Christ, you have the opportunity to ask Him. Instead of telling Him, Lord, forgive me for my sins. I'm sorry. I will follow you the rest of my day. You're my Lord and Savior. Thank you, Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It's that simple. His love for us is given. We have to remember that we open it up to be full of peace. When you don't feel joy, don't feel peace, you ask Him. The gift He's given us, you have to remember that. That's the Christmas service for today. We're going to close with one last song. And all of us are going to stand together and sing it. Worship team, come on up.